social media campaigns create an opportunity for the participant to actually do something in the real world. And I, you know, the best example I can think of was one several years ago by Greenpeace, which was called the Green My Apple campaign, in which they appealed to Mac users who love their Macs and love the brand to actually embrace that love and call on Steve Jobs and his game to green it. And I think that's a long story, and it should be looked at as a case study for what really works in that sense. And I think bringing that back to the UNFCCC context, what I'm seeing on Twitter, I think Durbin was the real first cop that really became a Twitter cop. And now I'm seeing this year so many negotiators on here and people who are commenting. I saw somebody commented the other day that the real conversations, that the more honest conversations are actually happening on Twitter as opposed to in the negotiations themselves. I saw a tweet by Connie Hedegaard yesterday in which she made a very critical comment about how whatever the Obama administration might have said, the fact is we're seeing the same old from the U.S. here in Doha, and I don't know that you would have actually said that in negotiating. I think the extent to which we can use those conversations putting pointed impact back on the negotiations is great. And